welcome to this special broadcast directly from our studios at Cornerstone Baptist Church in Oviedo, Florida. My name is Edgar Nazario, and today I have a special treat for all the women who are listening. But before that, I want to take a moment to invite you to our 2016 Women's Conference under the title Seeking the Glory of God with guest speakers Susan J. Hack and Martha Peace. Now stay tuned, because at the end of the broadcast, we will let you know how to register for this conference. All the ladies who will attend this year will definitely have a time of fellowship, joyful worship, and biblical teaching. And speaking of biblical teaching, this year we have the blessing to have two very special women who are very well known for their biblical teaching among women worldwide and their love for God's Word. I'm speaking about sisters Susan J. Hack and Martha Peace. Today we have the opportunity to have with us live via phone Martha Peace. Thanks for taking the time to join us on this broadcast, Martha.
Well, you're welcome, Edgar. I'm glad to be here.
Martha, thank you so much for joining us on this broadcast. We're very excited and thankful to once again have the opportunity to talk about our women's conference and the sessions that you will be teaching. Last time we talked, we looked at the first session you're going to be teaching with the title Trials, a Reminder of How Much We Need God. And you gave our listeners practical advice on how to face trials in a way that honors the Lord. And then today, I'd like to move to the second session, and the title for that is Modesty More Than a Change of Clothes. Martha, what should the ladies expect to hear in this very controversial subject, and what led you to bring up this topic for the conference in one of your sessions?
Well, all you have to do is go out in public and see what the problem is with how girls and ladies dress these days. The style is certainly very, very immodest. And one of my pastors, Kent Keller, and I wrote a book together. And the title of the book is Modesty More Than a Change of Clothes. And let me just tell you what our definition of modesty is. It's an inner attitude of the heart motivated by a love for God that seeks His glory through purity and humility. It often reveals itself in words, actions, expressions, and clothes. And we originally titled this book, before it was published, A Gold Ring in a Pig Snout. And that, we just loved our title, but P&R Publishers didn't like it. They wanted something more straightforward and plain, so they came up with this. But this, there's nothing like this material on the market that we could find. It is, each chapter has Martha's word to the girls and then Pastor Kent's word to the girls. And he goes back, we go back into the Old Testament, immodesty in the Old Testament, and then we talk about the New Testament, and then at the end, the practice of modesty. The challenge with this topic is to not be legalistic. It's very tempting to just, on chapter one, do this, don't do that, do this, you know, your skirt has to be this long, blah, blah, blah. The legalism chapter in this book, I think, is worth the price of the book. So we do give some practical advice at the end, but we build on what is in your heart. And if your heart is right with God, then this is not going to really be an issue for you. I remember going into a restaurant a while back, and my husband and I were with another couple, and I noticed this teenage girl coming in, and everybody noticed her because I thought, my goodness, she is practically naked. And then her mother came in, and I thought, she is naked. So, I mean, she really wasn't, but she might as well have been. And I thought, well, how sad for that young woman to have a mother who is like that and has encouraged her in that way. So this is something that we can glorify God or we can sin against God. And the sensuality, just the vanity that comes with all of that. And in 1 Timothy 2, it tells us that we are to be modest and discreet. And it doesn't mean we have to be ugly. It doesn't mean we have to look like Little House on the Prairie. But we can be stylish, and we can have fun with our makeup and clothes and enjoy the freedom that the Lord has given us. But we can be pure in our heart, and then that would show in our outward behavior.
In your opinion, Martha, and based on your experience of working with ladies from all parts of the world, what is causing Christian women to stumble in this particular area?
Well, it depends on where in the world you are. Last year I was in Uganda, Africa, and those ladies dress very modestly. They have long dresses. It's very hot there. It's on the equator. Their dresses are cotton, and they have short, puffy sleeves, and they're very colorful. They're very pretty, but they are very modest. So it just depends on where you are. In America and a lot of Europe, it's a real challenge, and it is especially hard on the men when women and teenage girls dress this way. And of course they need to be responsible for their own heart and their own thoughts, what they are thinking, but it's just, we should not make it harder on them than is necessary. And if we do that, a lot of teenage girls, I think, are naive about that. But once we teach them, and once we tell them, and once we show them in the scriptures, then if they continue to dress that way and act in a sensual way, then they really are acting like a harlot in their hearts. So it is a heart issue, but it shows in the outward behavior and also in the how you dress.
Thank you so much, Martha, for sharing with all of our women listeners a little bit of the great teaching that is to come.
You're welcome, Edgar. Thank you.
And for all the women who are out there who are listening, let me encourage you to register today and don't risk being left out, since we do have a limited amount of seating. Once again, come and join us in our 2016 Women's Conference under the title Seeking the Glory of God, with guest speakers Susan J. Heck and Martha Peace. This Women's Conference will be hosted at Cornerstone Baptist Church this coming 15th and 16th of July. All of our ladies will enjoy a time of fellowship, joyful worship, and biblical teaching, so take advantage and register today online by visiting www.seekinghisglory.net. I'll repeat that again, www.seekinghisglory.net. Or if you have questions, feel free to give us a call here at our studios at 407-971-7685. 407-971-7685. Thank you for listening, and we look forward to seeing you at our 2016 Women's Conference. God bless you.